Using the link in the description of my videos, go ahead and open up the Nitrado website. Now they're on the website, the first thing you need to do is go ahead here and create a free account with Nitrado if you don't have one, or if you do have one, go ahead and then log in. Once logged in, select products and then game server. From here, you just need to go ahead and select Ark. The first thing we need to do is decide if our server will be on a subscription or a prepaid basis. With a subscription, when the build date occurs, the money will be withdrawn from your account and your server will remain active. Prepaid, on the other hand, you'll get the server for however many days, and if you do not pay before the due date, your server will be deleted. Prepaid is great for those who are interested in hosting their own servers but are not 100% sold on the idea. A subscription, on the other hand, is fantastic for those who host clusters, as you'll never need to worry about the servers expiring and losing all your hard work. Alright, so we can go ahead and choose one of the server packages recommended, or we can create our own one. So starting with the recommended package, the differences between them is the max number of players that can be on the server at once, hence the price differences. Once you've found the package you want, go ahead and change the platform to what you need it to be. And then once you've got the platform that you need, go ahead and then choose the location for the server. Alternatively, if you go ahead and click customize server, you'll need to first select the platform it's going to be running on, and then you need to scroll down. All right, so the first thing we need to do is choose the max amount of players we want on the server at one time. And then from there, you need to decide how many real life days the server is going to be running for. As you can see, by editing those two sliders, the amount we have to pay varies. Lastly, scroll down and choose where your server is going to be hosted. By doing a latency test, Nitrado is going to tell you where to host the server to allow you to get the best gaming experience. Do keep in mind your player base. If people live far away from the server, they're going to experience more ping. So for example, by choosing my Sydney option here, my American friend will lag a lot more on my server because my server is further from where they live. With that all being said though, I'm going to scroll up and choose the most popular option. From here you need to select your payment method, and if you want your purchase to be 10% cheaper, go ahead and use my promo code Ninjakiller10. And then from there, just purchase your server. Now that the server is purchased, go ahead and grab a cup of tea with some bikkies or play on another game for about 30 minutes. As right now, Nitrado needs a bit of time to fully set up the server before you can edit with no issues. Once the server is set up, you can press the set up your server button from the previous page, or if you're in the main menu, click on your name and then my services. Now this page is where you're going to see all your Nitrado services listed. And then from here, you want to go ahead and click the cog symbol next to your server, which will load you up to its dashboard. From here, stop the server, and once it's stopped, head to general. And once in general, you can go ahead and start building your server. I'm going to cover all this in a future video though. For those that are still on the fence of owning their own server, let me tell you some of the reasons why you should get your own one. First things first, you don't need to deal with that silly host barrier that people have on their non-dedicated worlds. Instead, you and your mates can start on a fresh world and have zero limitations and go wherever you want, whenever you want. You can also edit your game files, allowing you to make various changes, such as editing what is in loot drops. And lastly, you can grow an awesome community where you can have so much fun on a regular basis, just like in the footage being shown right now from Archive Season 1. Thank you for watching my video. I hope this helped you get your own Switch server. If you have any questions though, please let me know in the comments and I will do my best to assist you. And with that being said, I'll see you in the next video. Take care.